This is new topic, potential energy, electric potential energy. So if you see the definition of electric potential energy, to bring a charge from infinity to a certain distance with constant speed, then work done by force is called potential energy. Obviously it's external force and negative of that work done. Whatever work done will get, negative of work done. It means, what's the meaning of this statement? We have to bring one charge from infinity to a certain distance with constant speed. So obviously there will be work done on that charge. So whatever work done is there, so I will take negative of that work done, negative of that external force, negative of work done by external force, so that itself a potential energy. So if I go by this definition, let's say this charge is Q, and at long distance from this one, okay, let's say this charge is Q1, at long distance, there is another charge Q2. So according to this definition, I have to bring this charge Q2 towards Q1 at certain distance. So there will be some work done due to this electrostatic force. So whatever work done will be there, that will store as a potential energy. So how to calculate that potential energy? I'll find out that work done, and negative of work done by external force, that will become potential energy. Now, so if I bring this charge from this point to this one, it's a very long distance. Let's say this distance is infinity. Distance between these two infinity. So if I bring this charge Q2 towards Q1 and Q2 reach at this point, here Q2 is here at this point, and this distance is R. Distance between these two R. Now, first I bring this charge Q2 from this point to this one, and again I displace this Q2 very small distance dr. This distance is dr, it's a very small distance, and this distance is r. This one is r, so this one will be dr minus r minus dr, but dr is very small. So actually what I am telling, this distance between Q1 and Q2, distance between this point A and point C is R, but distance between point A and point B, that is also R, because that dr is very small. So what I did, first I bring this charge Q2 to point C, then again I displace this charge Q2 to a small distance dr. So this will be the displacement dr. Now, I need to calculate work done in this whole process. So, work done in this whole process, W is equal to, that will be F dot dr. This will be work done formula, F dot dr. So, we know F is equal to K Q1 Q2 divided by R square, because it's an electrostatic force. In place of F, what I write? K Q1 Q2 divided by R square. Now, what will be integration limit? See, in the definition, we have to bring charge from infinity to a certain distance. It means lower limit is what? Infinity, and upper limit is what? R. Infinity to R. So, we have to bring this charge from infinity to R. So, this work done itself a potential energy. I'll calculate this thing. So dr as it is, in place of F, what I am writing, you know, Coulomb force, F is equal to K Q1 Q2 divided by R square. Just in place of this F, I wrote that. Now, I take that K Q1 Q2 outside, and integration of 1 by R square, that is here, at infinity to R. And we know integration of 1 by R square, that will be minus 1 by R. Basically, this is the formula for R power n integration dr. What we write, R power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. This is the basic formula for integration. Now, R power minus 2, this 1 upon R square, what I can write? R power minus 2, if I take this one denominator outside, in that case, that will become R power minus 2. R power minus 2 dr. So, if I solve this one, R power minus 2 plus 1 divided by R power this minus 2 plus 1. So if I solve this one, I'll get minus 1 by R. Means integration of 1 by r square, that will be minus 1 by r. So if I put this value, so I will get k, q1, q2, and this one will be minus 1 divided by r, and this will be infinity to r. Now, as we know, first I put upper limit with minus sign, I put lower limit. So if I put upper limit and minus sign, lower limit, so what I will get over here? K, q1, q2, here minus 1 by r plus 1 by infinity. I put this value. So here I will get k, q1, q2 divided by r with minus sign. But by definition, the negative of work done is potential energy. So negative of this work done means what will write? Negative of this work done. So negative sign I will get this side. So what I will get finally? Finally I will get W is equal to minus W is equal to K Q1 Q2 divided by R. So this is formula for potential energy. So by definition, potential energy is equal to K Q1 Q2 divided by R. And obviously it's energy, so you know what will be unit of this one, joule, and what will be dimension, ml square t bar minus 2. And it's energy, so obviously it's a scalar quantity, it's not a vector, it's a scalar quantity. So whenever you have to find out energy of a system, so what we'll do, simply we add, just like energy between q1, q2, q3, q4, so without any direction we need to add for energy. For example, if this is question, this one is equilateral triangle. In equilateral triangle, distance between that charge is, these three charges, distance between these three charges, let's say this one Q, this one Q, this one Q, distance between these three A, is equal at a triangle. So if I ask you what's the potential energy of this system, so simply potential energy of this system, so energy between these two, what I can write? K, Q1, Q2 divided by R. Similarly, energy between these two, K, Q1, Q2 divided by R. In place of R, what is there? A. Between these two, what I can write? K Q2 Q3 divided by R. In place of R, what is there? A. And for this one, what I can write? K Q3 Q1 divided by A. And you know Q1 is equal to Q2 is equal to Q3. So all are equal. So in place of Q1, I write Q, Q2 also Q, Q3 also Q. So if I simplify this one a bit, what I get? Energy between these two, so I'll get k q square divided by a, and this one also k q square divided by a, this one same thing, what I'll get from here, 3k q square. Means simply you have to add in magnitude because it's a scalar quantity. Now, one another question based on this topic, let's say this one is one rectangle, not rectangle, it's a square. This distance A, this one A, this charge Q, this one is Q, this one is Q, this one is Q, this one is Q. So what I want to find out, potential energy of this system. So obviously potential energy of this one, 4K Q square divided by A. Plus, this is due to sides. Four sides are there, 1, 2, 3, 4. So due to first one, KQ square by A. Second one, KQ square by A. Third also, KQ square by A. So 4 kq square by a due to this side. Now this distance how much? Root 2a. And this distance also root 2a. So due to first diagonal what I write? Kq square divided by root 2a square. No, root, not root 2a square, only root 2a. Due to second diagonal what I write? Kq square divided by root 2a. If I add this whole thing, so what I'll get? You can take common, kq square divided by a, we can take common. This one will be 4 plus 2 divided by root 2. And if I simplify this whole thing, so what I'll get? Kq square divided by a, and that will be 4 plus root 2. So this is potential energy of this system.